Is there sound now, Corinda? Now, hopefully, there is sound. Go on, Corinda, tell me, baby. Sound, come on, give me sound. Yeah. Yep, we got sound. We got sound, I can see myself on there. I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to quickly see whether I can't just get myself back on Amazon as well. And then we can carry on as if nothing happened. Oh, dear, oh, dear, the joys of live streaming. Okay, let's, I'm going to very quickly just set this up on, on Amazon. Give that one more chance. And then we can get cooking. Obviously, I'm going to be cooking a bit quicker now. So that's good. I can hear you all saying, yeah, get on with it, Woody. No problem. Let's do that. Okay, that will do for now. That'll do. Let's wipe that on. And so on Amazon, you have to set up your carousel, really. You do anything without a carousel. Just quickly call it Keto Nick Cooking Show. Thank you so much for staying with me. I really do appreciate it. I'm going to use it on external cameras, save that. That all now looks good to go. So I'm going to preview that, hopefully. That's going to pick up the live stream really fast. And, okay, 3, 2, 1, and we're back in the room. So we're now on Amazon. So hi, everybody. Hi, everyone on Amazon. Send that. Hopefully, let's double click on... on the Nickwood page. That would be awesome if we can actually get that going as well. Nickwood.live, and that will take you to my Amazon page, which is really cool. And there you can see in the bottom corner, hopefully, yes, there I am. Hallelujah, he's back. Fantastic. Right, well, there you go. We are now brilliantly back on. Okay, I see you on Facebook. Amazon is white. No, we're good, Corinda. We are all good. It is now back on Amazon. It is back on Facebook. Hallelujah. Right. Now, where were we? Okay. I see your Facebook, your Amazon is white. Now, I can see my Amazon, Corinda. It's cool. I'm watching my Amazon right now, and we are live on Amazon. Brilliant. Okay. But not bad echo. Yeah, a bit echo. Shouldn't be echo. There's only one. Marina, yeah. Ah, is that why? That could be it. Okay, try that. Hopefully that has now fixed it. Works great now. Marina, thank you so much. And this is, I tell you what, this is one of the joys, one of the things I love about live streaming. You guys that watch me, you're so helpful. You shout out when it's going wrong, and I love it. So thank you so much for that. Okay, quick recap now that we're all back on. Right, back on Amazon, back on Facebook, back on YouTube, all over the internet. And, wait. Ooh. Marina, still the same issue. Still echoey. Is that if you have Amazon, Facebook open, you're watching stream. Yeah. No, see, I've got it all off now. That should be everything off. So hopefully that's okay now. It might be because I'm picking up my, feels like I have a stream somewhere else. No, definitely don't. No, that is so, so weird. Let me just have a little check on that one. That should all be good. Sorry about that. We just have tech issues at times. Not to worry. So listen, if you go and if you want to go and check out, watch it on Amazon, maybe there's no echo there, and you can still comment. That's all good. No matter where we are, we can do it on Amazon or all the other platforms. You still elements where you can now it's good, perfect. There's always places you can still comment, which is cool. And this is what I love about Be Live or Be.live, is that you can then drop the links into the comment section, so you can go see me on Amazon. Brilliant. Oh, John, thank you very much indeed, John. John saying it's no echoes here either. Fantastic. So it's good now. Thank you, Rihanna. Fantastic. And hi to John. And hi also to Corinda. Hi, Corinda. Thank you so much for helping me out there, everybody. Superb. Okay. What am I waking today? That's a darn fine question. Well, as you can see, I've got this, as I was saying, I can't remember where I got up to, but basically, my sister, bless her, came and bought me a load of, fresh from her allotment in Odium, some pak choi. So I'm going to make some, which is basically cabbage in all intents and purposes. So I'm going to make a quick cabbage soup. It's lunchtime, so I fancy soup for lunch. And it's super keto friendly as well. For those who don't know, the reason it's called Keto Nick is because I've lost 48 pounds since the end of January. And 38 of those were since the 10th of May. And that is purely by going on a keto diet. And not even hardcore keto. I think people probably call it lazy keto or something like that. But basically, I just took out the big carbs. So the big carbs being bread, pasta, rice, and potatoes. Took those out, started walking 45 minutes a day, and that is how I got the weight loss down. So that is what's all about. So that's why. And it's a lifestyle, so it's cool. So yeah, so we're gonna have soup. And then Corinda, we're also going to have a no-bake cheesecake because I've got the ingredients. I was supposed to have the cook-off with Adair earlier in the week, but she couldn't make it. But I've got the ingredients, so easy peasy. Cream cheese, double cream. I'll make a slightly non-keto biscuit base, but it's keto friendly if you only have a little slice. And yeah, so that'll be it. So that'll be cheesecake and to help you with 48 pound loss. Yeah, exactly, John. I need to sell my trousers, to be honest. It's that good. Right, let me put in the auto assistant on for the comments, so hopefully they'll come up. First things first, and as I was saying, on Amazon it's in the carousel. Now we're on Amazon again. But also what I love about Be Live is if you're watching on YouTube or Facebook, then I can actually drop the link so you can check it out as well in the comments. So hopefully that link will drop in the comments as well, and that will be the affiliate link to my Circulon pan set, which I love using. So there you go, there it is. You can go check them out. So let's get a little start on. I'm going to get some stock first of all, because that cabbage, whilst delicious on its own, it ain't gonna be that great. So I keep my stock cubes in a little tin. What I'm going to do is I'm going to do part chicken, part vegetable. Chicken is, chicken stock is, a real base flavour for a lot of things. So if this was for a vegetarian, obviously I would, I wouldn't put chicken stock in, but as this is for me, that's cool. Let me take that off now. Hide that. Perfect. So it's just going to take two stock cubes, and these stock cubes, basically they're going to make 500 grams milliliters of stock. So just plain stock that you can get anywhere. You can get it on Amazon as well, with Amazon's amazing delivery and food service. So you can get those stocks there. Just going to crumble them in. And go in the bin, and I better get some water. And if you're watching earlier, you've got my My laptop is sitting rather precariously. Rather precariously above the sink. So I'm trying very hard not to drop it in. So right, let's get that stock on the go first of all. Get that under a high heat. Perfect. Right, that stock will go to the boil and start to bubble up nicely, all dissolve and will look amazing. So we've got our pak choi. I guess you can get beef stock. Yeah, you can get beef stock as well, Corinda, but that would be a little bit too heavy for the... Hello, Brittany, as well. What are you cooking on Amazon? Yeah, that would be too heavy. So Brittany, watching on Amazon, thank you so much. Thank you for the comment as well. I'm making a cheesecake, a no-bake cheesecake, first of all. I'm making a soup, as my sister brought me this lovely fresh pak choi from her garden. So in order to roughly chop it up, and this is, you know, I love making soup. It's one of those things that it doesn't actually inspire a lot of people to when you're making soup. They go, oh, really, is that all? But actually, homemade soup is absolutely stunning. If you then go and get a tin, I won't mention the brand. It's you suddenly realise just how sweet some of these tinned soups are, which is not so good. And also, the reason I love cooking is I get to know and I get to control everything that that goes in the pan. So I'm totally relaxed about that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get that on the go. So with that stock there, let me just move. There's cooking cam. So now you can see, let's move my killer ninja out of the way. So basically we're just gonna boil up that. So that's only gonna take literally about 10 minutes, not even that. I'm just gonna go and grab a lid as well. Sorry about that, I couldn't find my lid. So let's pop a lid on that. And so yeah, that will take about 10 minutes to cook. Super, super easy. So Brittany, watching on Amazon, please do let us know what you'd like us to cook next. We're on back on Monday with my good friend Stephen Healy, where we go through all our live streaming equipment, and we have an amazing, really fun film-based quiz that we throw into the mix as well. And then also on Tuesday, hopefully, because she does live on a boat and is susceptible to weather and all sorts, we have the England Australia or Australia England cook-off with the lovely Adair. She doesn't have an oven, so she's really restricted, but we have good fun. We have a good cook-off. And then again, we've got the new show on Thursdays. Now the move is complete, I can say. We've got the show on Thursday. It was supposed to be on last night. And that's going to be more about cooking techniques. So, basically things, how to make some amazing sauces. I mean, that sauce will elevate pretty much anything. We'll probably throw in some one-pot keto meals into that as well. And then, of course, back on the Friday Keto Nick, where I cook my lunch. Brittany saying, oh, I love the emojis, Brittany. Thank you very much. Very much appreciated. Soups are comforting and delicious, especially in the colder months. I love learning to make new soup recipes, new products. Oh, thank you so much, Brittany. Really appreciate that. If you haven't already, please do hit the follow button and then you'll just get a notification when we're next live. So with this soup, what you could do, I mean, a traditional way to thicken the soup is to add a potato. But of course, with a low carb ketonic style, we can't really add a potato. So I can do a couple of things. I can either thicken it, if I want to thicken it, I could thicken it with arrowroot, something like that, just a little bit. Or I'm just, actually on this one, I'm just going to leave it as is. So I'm going to blitz it, but I'm only going to blitz it a little bit. I'll use a stick blender for that as well. And because there's so much pak choi in there, that will be fairly thick anyway. Can we have a, Corinda saying, can we have a tour of the studio? Well, it's, as you can see, Corinda, it is just the kitchen. So that's all we've got there. And how many lettery on the cheesecake? How have you lettery on the cheesecake? Sorry, Corinda, how do you have it? No, it's going to be a nice plain cheesecake. So it'll basically be a... it's going to be a what's the word I'm looking for? Vanilla, the vanilla cheesecake. And the reason I like it as vanilla is because then you can add. So I've got some blueberries, so I can make a little. I'll add a few blueberries on the top, and I'll probably blitz up some blueberries, make a little blueberry coulis as well. So that'd be good. Have you ever made a lamb burger? I have, yeah, lamb burgers, use lamb mincs. A bit like with the meatballs last week. Well, that's beginning to boil up. Yeah, a bit like the meatballs we made last week. Again, use the mince, add in the, traditionally you would be adding in breadcrumbs and milk to bind it. But I used, what did I use? I used almond flour and milk, made that into a little paste, and that bound the mince. And just make it into a burger shape, Corinda, absolutely. You know what, you can make biscuit for children in need. Ah, that's an idea, Corinda. Make biscuits for children in need. That's a good charity, isn't it? I like that idea. I like that idea, but I'd need to find some keto-friendly biscuits, that's for sure. So that's coming along. That's good. We don't want that to... breakdown. Right, now what we can do, let's get a start on our cheesecake. So what I've got here is, as I say, got some lovely blueberries, normal just cream cheese, that's all good. Oh, my connection keeps going off and on. Oh, that's so frustrating, Corinda. So frustrating. What can you do? What can you do? Not a lot is the honest answer. Okay. Cheesecake. Oh. Cheesecake is going to need my good friend. My good friend, the KitchenAid. We need to make sure that goes on nicely. And these are great. I'm going to move it so I can open it. And if you've never felt the weight of a KitchenAid mixer, they are really heavy, but they're good. And that's the thing, they are, you know, you can use them. They mix forever and a day. You've got a huge motor on them. They never burn out. They are just awesome, awesome pieces of kit. And what we're going to do is, because I'm about to use it, I'm going to pop it in the... I'm going to pop it in the carousel on Amazon. Unfortunately, I've not gone through the whole of getting the link into the BeLive, but not to worry. So let me plug this in. Let me unplug that. Plug this one. Okay, so let's get on to. I could do with a bit better lighting, couldn't I? Let's see what that's got there. That's better. Now you can see the KitchenAid better. There you go. Let's make that KitchenAid cam now. Perfect. Check that out. This is it. Yeah, this is my favorite. I'll be honest, this is my favorite piece of kitchen equipment. You've got 10 speeds. You have the whisk. You've got a bow hook. You've got a K paddle.
A few weeks ago, I made guacamole. So that was avocados, onions, chilies, etc., lime juice. And I used a K paddle to blend all that in together. That was awesome. But now, whisk today. So we're going to whisk up a combo of cream cheese. I'm doing things back to front here. That's better. We're going to whisk up some cream cheese. Don't know why that has just appeared. Hopefully, I'm still alive. Cream cheese, double cream. We're going to add to that some agar. So, traditionally, to sweeten a cheesecake, then we'd add icing sugar. But because icing sugar, that's a bit of a no-no on the keto diet, we're going to be using something called agar, which is like a natural, it's a natural sweetener. So it's unprocessed, which is always a good thing. Less carbs. So that's our cream cheese all in there. Fantastic. I'll tell you what, actually, I might just make it a blueberry cheesecake anyway. Why don't I do that? Now I'm gonna move the cooking can because I need to get to this cupboard. Down boy. Get the agar out. Then the camera could go horribly, wrong with the camera there. This is where's the agar? Here it is. This is agave syrup. Okay, so we just pop a little bit of that in. We don't need a great deal, literally like a teaspoon. That's all we need for that. That I got from my vegan chocolate making kit. I'm not a vegan, but oh, we nearly got very up close and personal. Let's get that back up there. There you go. Look at that. How to progress. Okay, I need a KitchenAid in my life as much cooking and baking as I do. It's an addition to the kitchen I need. Yeah, I tell you what, Brittany, yeah, if you can get one. And I've often say this is a quick tip in manifesting is pop it in your click it on the carousel because you're watching on Amazon and add it to your wish list. That way you get that you start that vibration and who knows, worst that can happen is someone actually sees it on your wish list and buys it for you. Who knows? Live bloopers are the best. I thank you. You're very forgiving, Brittany. I really do appreciate that. Right, so I've got the cream cheese, the agar. I will actually. I'm gonna pop a couple of blueberries in. Let's do that. And see what that does to the mixture. What I'll do though is I'll start to. Who am I kidding? Let's just pour the thick cream. So depending where you live, so we call this double cream. I think in the States you call it heavy cream, or you could have whipping cream, but a good thick cream will do. Let's never want to waste. Let's scrape that off the packet as well. Get all that in there. Perfect. My fingers are clean. That's good. Quickly wash them again. The smell of the soup that we got on the go is beginning to smell really beautiful, really gorgeous. And that'll be ready really soon. That locks in there like that. Pop our KitchenAid back down. Now, because I've got the cream and the cream cheese mixed together, I'm mixing them together, so I don't want it to be on a fast whisk. start fairly slowly. And that's the thing. That's the thing about the KitchenAid, is that the bowl is designed so that the whisk captures every part of that bowl. It is really, really cool. Hey, a bear. I'm making the no-bake cheesecake that we were going to make, but we never got round to it yet. I have the ingredients, so I make it. So, great to see you there. That is my great friend here. We have our show normally on a Tuesday at 9 a.m. in the UK, which I believe is 7 p.m. In the Brisbane time zone. So we can see you on Tuesday, hopefully. Maybe we can have another go at the cheesecake. I'll call this one a practice. So that's now coming together, blending really nicely. Which is good. Oh yeah. That is looking lovely. Looking lovelier and lovelier by the moment. So here we go. That's it. Need to keep a little eye on it, because there you go. That is delicious. That is really, really nice. Love that. Right, let me put that extra cream there. Now, so that's our cream cheese, our cream cheesecake mix done. So it's just get that off there. And get my spoon. See, now look, if I wasn't doing this on a live show, you know as well as I do that I would be going full in licky, licky, licky. it's just delicious. Come on, I don't want to miss any. I want to get it all out. Come on, baby. Get it all out. You see, this is a... I'm gonna gently bash it. That'll have to do. But there we go. There's our cream cheesecake mixture. Yummy, yummy, yummy. And so, yeah, Brittany, you definitely need a KitchenAid. They are awesome. Let me switch that off. Because now we need a little base to put it on, don't we? That was the thing. So let's put my KitchenAid over here. Oops. God, I thought I was going to take the table with it. Okay, so let's set that aside for a moment. Over here, do. I'm still getting used to this new kitchen, so forgive me if I can't find things. Right, let's just slice up some of these. Blueberries. Obviously, do try not to cut your fingers when you're slicing. So, I always like to keep my fingers above the blade. And these are going to be lovely. These are, I don't want them too, I don't want them really small, but they want them to be small enough so that they're just going to be little pops of blueberry flavour into that cheesecake mix. I'll just pop in there very quickly. Good morning. That's that done. And now, yeah, we just want to make a little mix, don't we? So let's grab a... This I hope you like. This is it's a bit chefy, but I love doing these. All right, turn that right down. You can use these as a cutter. I need to find these on Amazon so I can put them in the carousel. But yeah, you have these, and this is a Berghoff. Should be on Amazon. And basically, we're going to make our cheesecake, set it in the mold, and we're going to be good to go. So first of all, let's get a nice little plate. That one will do. And I'm just going to give the top a little wipe down. That's good. Okay. So this is where we're going to plate it. Let's make sure that's, see that? That's good. That's all good. Corinda just made apple crumble for later. Children need, lovely. So Corinda, am I being stupid? Is it children in need today? I don't watch TV, so I don't know these things, unfortunately. Now, this is going to be a little bit of a cheat. But because this is a small cheesecake, that is a perfect size. Now, what you can do, and if you're going to make a big cheesecake, right. Thanks, Corinda. I'll send them a donation. All right, these are my mother-in-law's biscuits. So we better not tell her what I'm using. But they actually do fit the mold perfectly. So that's why I'm using them. But if you're making a bigger cheesecake, then yeah, just grab some digestive biscuits, put them in a plastic bag or in a bit of cling film, bash them to make them a crumb, add to that, just melt some butter, pour the butter on, and it will make a nice little base. But because it's already in a nice, perfect base form, I'm just going to use the biscuit. But that's super easy. And if I'm looking over the way, because I've got Amazon there and I've got the camera and everything else there. So let's pop that over our mold. Let's grab our cheesecake and my spoon. So we've got those lovely little blueberries now in our cheesecake mix. And literally, I need another spoon to do this. What we're going to do is we're just going to add that into our mold. And what we want is it, let's pop that spoon there, and push it down because you want it to be nice and full of cream cheese and cream and the agave, which has sweetened it. It's just such a clever little product. And again, take acid, give it a nice squeeze down. Now, hopefully that is now sitting on the, that is sitting on the biscuit base. And let's get one more bit at the top. There you go. There's some cream cheese, or rather cheesecake mix left over for me for afters. Shut that door, was I born in the barn? And this is the thing, this is what I love. So this comes with different shape, different size cutters, okay? And different size plungers. So what we do is we just screw in our plunger of choice. Get a nice wipe, so it'll come off. And what would happen if you wanted to, we could put that in the fridge. Ideally, we put it in the fridge for a couple of hours, let it set properly before we do this. But I just want to demonstrate this. I'll put it in the fridge as well. And that is, we just pop our plunger on the top. And that way we know, yeah, that is done. Now, if you refrigerated it, I do have a little blowtorch that would release it. But actually, this is so cool, because you just plunge it and you just gently raise it up. And there you have a lovely cheesecake. Now, what we do need to do, just gently with the tip of a knife, take our plunger off. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is a beautiful blueberry cheesecake, which I'm now going to pop into the fridge and let that chill and set. Perfect. Okay, so while we've been doing that, our soup has been on the go. And that soup, I was using my lovely Herculon saucepans. Really good. They come with pretty much lifetime guarantees. Awesome things. Obviously, don't abuse them, otherwise they all look crazy. All right, now, so I'm keeping some blueberries back for the cheesecake, and then decorate the cheesecake later. So that is that. But let's finish off with the soup. So I'm going to pop that on there so you can see. So you can see that has broken down beautifully. So I'm just going to go grab one of my stick blender. One stick blender, have a stick blender, will travel. And all we're going to do, is blend it. So hopefully you can blend it without getting it everywhere, and it will all be good. So nice and gently, just blend it down. Consistent. Okay. And look at that. That is now a delicious deep green colour because of the pak choi. And that's the thing, you know, when you, it's lovely being able to make your own, because yeah, that was, you saw the depth of colour in that pak choi when I put it on. And now you can see, I'll move my camera slide. Hopefully you can see that is now soup cam. And that is the beautiful pak choi soup. So pretty much cabbage soup in anyone else's language. So that's really delicious. We obviously do need to taste it and check it for seasoning. I didn't put any salt and pepper in at the beginning because we used those stock cubes, and the stock cubes actually have actually quite salty in them anyway. That is really nice. I will put a little bit of salt in though. That's delicious. Nice bit of rock salt in. Put some ground pepper in. It's really, you can taste the iron. Is that good with my? Let's get another spoon. I guess wooden spoon to stir it. That is delicious. And again, so if you know, we can use potatoes to thicken it, but actually that's a really thick soup already. And it's just, that is delicious. So get a little bowl of soup and a ladle. So yeah, that pak choy was in the ground growing yesterday, and it was thanks to my lovely little sister that brought that around and has allowed me to make that beautiful little pak choy soup, which is absolutely delicious, super super simple. So what we've got today, we've got soup, and here is the cheesecake as well. Now I'm gonna, while the soup cools down, I'm going to just add some blueberries on the top. Then just try and decorate it a little bit. And this was when I was at the Raymond Blanc Cookery School. We did a raspberry charlotte, which we decorated with raspberries. Unsurprisingly, on the top, and we actually made a beautiful little syrupy glaze as well, that we poured over. But I was commended for my raspberries. That they were so regimental, they were like little soldiers sitting on the top. You get the picture. And also, you could just literally blend these up, because we kind of ran out of time. But you could actually blend these up, pass it through a sieve, and have a lovely blueberry coulis as well. So, which is pretty damn awesome. We do love that. So, here's our lovely cheesecake. And what's not to love on a Friday? Doesn't get much better. And I've got the additional cream, so I could also whip that up. And suddenly you have an amazing cheesecake with gorgeous double cream. Not an oven in sight. So it is a. Yeah, I was going so well. I was going to just slightly adjust that one and then pop that one on there. That's it. So there we have it. That today was our lovely blueberry cheesecake, with blueberry topping, blueberry around the inside, little pockets of blueberry. And first of all, our lovely, thanks to my sister, I'll try not to throw it everywhere. The lovely pak choy soup, which is beautiful. So there you go. Two really easy meals. Sorry about all the hassles earlier on when we were getting thrown off air and then we had to reset. Very strange stuff. But I hope you've enjoyed it. I hope you found that interesting. And so until, have a great weekend, whatever you're doing. Obviously, if you're watching on Amazon, please do hit the follow button and you get notification when we're live again. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed that. Let me know what you're cooking over the weekend. Chuck it in the comments, put it in the messages. I'd love to know. And whatever you're doing, enjoy it. And so please do let us know what you're cooking, what you want to see cooked next. Obviously, we got the cook-off on Tuesday. Might be cheesecake again. Might not be. Now you've seen that. But we will see what the day wants to do. But I will see you on Monday with Stephen Healy when we go through what we use for our live streaming. That's always good fun. And we have an amazing film-based quiz, which Corinda was amazing with, which was brilliant. And then I will see you on Tuesday with Adair. Then again on Thursday, that's Thursday evening at 6:30 p.m. in the UK, and that's just a lovely little cooking show which will teach you how to make sauces and all that sort of thing. Just to zhuzh up some of your meals. And then we're back again with the Keto Nick cooking show on Friday, where I cook lunch. Okay, listen, whatever you're doing, have an amazing weekend, and I will see you all very, very soon. So we've got to say goodbye to our friends on Amazon. We've got to end that stream. Au revoir.
farewell, Amazon friends, and a massive thank you, and farewell, my beautiful Facebook and YouTube.